Hello everyone, we are discussing the VARC section of CAT 2020 paper which was given in slot 2. In this video, let's try to solve question number 5 to question number 8 from second RC given in the paper. Before we start solving the questions, let's understand the passage and try to summarize the main points so that we are more comfortable while eliminating the wrong options. So this is a very simple passage from social psychology. And the first paragraph of the passage defines aggressive behavior, and it says for something to be termed as aggressive behavior, the victim of the behavior should be willing to avoid it. That is the basic definition given. Then it goes on to say how there are diverse behaviors which can be termed as aggressive, and that's why there is a need for different theories or models to characterize those behaviors. And these theories or models, they use different variables which are present whenever any aggressive act or set of acts is committed. The first variable is aggressor, the second the social situation, and the third one is the victim of aggression. In the second paragraph, he narrows it down to the theories and research on the aggressor, and he says that the fundamental focus is on the factors that lead an individual to commit aggressive acts. So among those factors, the ones that are mentioned are biological factors and hormonal factors. Biological are the inborn ones. And one theory that is from Freud mentions that there is a strong death instinct among human beings, and that leads to aggressive behavior. Other perspectives say that there is less neural control on acts of aggression in human beings. The third one says that we have a strong instinct for accumulating property and territorialism, and that leads to different wars and acts of aggression. The hormonal factors are simply presence or absence of higher levels of testosterone, which can be responsible for aggressive behavior. So basically, this is what is given in the passage. We will keep this in mind when we start eliminating the options. So let's go to question number 5. Question 5 says, the author identifies 3 essential factors according to which theories of aggression are most commonly categorized. Which of the following options is closest to the factors identified by the author? So what we have to do is, we have to go back to the first paragraph. From our summary, we remember that this information was given somewhere in the last part of the first paragraph where he talked about the variables. So we will get our answer from this part of the passage. The first variable is the aggressor himself. The second is the social situation or circumstance. And the third one is the victim. So this is a very, very easy question because the correct option can be spotted easily and the other options are not even close to the correct option. So let's see what the other options say. First one says hostile, instrumental, hormonal. Makes no sense. This can be eliminated. The second one says aggressor. That is given as the first variable, circumstances of aggression, which is given as the second variable, and the victim himself, victim or the target, so that is given as the third variable. So this is a direct question from the passage and we can easily mark our answer here. But for the sake of discussion, we will try to eliminate the other two options as well. So extreme, moderate, mild, nowhere mentioned in the passage. Psychologically, sociologically, medically, nowhere mentioned in the passage. So these are irrelevant options. This is extrinsic information. So we'll come back to option number 2 and aggressor, circumstances of aggression, and victim. These are the 3 variables, and this is the answer that we will mark for this question. Question number 6 says, an enemy combatant may be subjected to torture in order to extract useful intelligence, though those inflicting the torture may have no real feelings of anger or animosity towards their subject. Which one of the following best explicates the larger point being made by the author here? This question is asking you to explain the larger point being made by the author through the statement which is given in the quotation marks. And we remember from our summary that this information was given first part of the passage where the author was talking about aggression being hostile or aggression being instrumental. So let's go back to this part of the paragraph. Instrumental aggression is an aggressive act that is regarded as a means to an end other than pain or injury. That means the act which has no motive to inflict pain or injury, it just uses aggression to or to achieve a particular end. So let's go back to the question and start eliminating the options. First option says, information revealed by subjecting an enemy combatant to torture is not always reliable because of the animosity involved. Whether the information is reliable or not reliable is not the larger point that is being made by the author. The author has previously mentioned that aggressive behaviors can be categorized based on the intent. The option has to be related to intent of the person who is inflicting the torture. So whether the information that he extracts is reliable or not reliable is immaterial. So this is irrelevant option, not coming from the passage. So we can eliminate this option here only. Second one says, when an enemy combatant refuses to reveal information, the use of torture can sometimes involve real feelings of hostility. So this is again extension of what is given in the passage. In the situation where the person is not revealing information, what is done next, that is beyond the scope of what is given in the passage. So this is an out of scope option. So second one is also eliminated. The third option says, the use of torture to extract information is most effective when the torturer is not emotionally involved in the torture. Nowhere mentioned in the first paragraph where this particular statement is given. Whether the person is detached or the person is involved is not important. What was the intent of inflicting that torture? That is more important in categorizing the behavior. Third one is also eliminated. Fourth one says, in certain kinds of aggression, that is the instrumental aggression, inflicting pain is not the objective, that is what is meant, given in the passage, and is no more than a utilitarian means. Utilitarian means it is considered to be just a way to achieve some end, that is given in the paragraph itself, in the passage. And that's why this is the option which actually paraphrases what is given in the passage in this context. So this is your correct option. The other three we've already eliminated. Question 7 says, all of the following statements can be seen as logically implied by the arguments of the passage, except. So this instruction or this way of framing the question means that three options are logically implied and one isn't. And the one that isn't is your answer. The first option says, the Freudian theory of suicide as self-inflicted aggression implies that an aggressive act need not be sought to be avoided in order for it to be considered aggression. So this option is confusing because in the first paragraph of the passage, the author mentions that for any behavior to be marked as aggressive, there should be a wish to avoid such behavior in the victim. This is something that is mentioned in the definition of aggressive behavior itself. But then when we read this part in conjunction with the second paragraph, and Sigmund Freud says that all individuals are born with a death instinct that predisposes us to a variety of aggressive behaviors, including suicide. Any act of aggression is not avoided by people who are born with this death instinct. So from this part, we can understand that first option is valid option. Second option says, Freud's theory of aggression proposes that aggression results from the suppression of aggressive urges. So he says that we have a predisposition for different aggressive behaviors because we've got a death instinct, a very strong death instinct. And the first behavior that is mentioned is suicide. The second one that is mentioned is mental illness. And that mental illness is possibly due to an unhealthy or unnatural suppression of aggressive urges. That is what our option talks about. So let's read the option again. Freud's theory of aggression proposes that aggression results from suppression of aggressive Arjay. So this part, this option comes from that part that we just went back to. The third option says a common theory of aggression is that it is the result of an abnormally low neural regulation of testosterone. Let's see if we can find this information. This information can be found written where? This part of the passage which says that humans evolved with an abnormally low neural inhibition of aggressive impulses in comparison to other species. So now when we compare this information that is given in the passage to the option given in the question, we know this option is trying to confuse us by using information which comes from later part of the passage where hormonal factors are being discussed. This information is found where biological factors are being discussed. So this is a combination of two different pieces of information mentioned in the passage, and that's why this cannot be inferred from the passage. The passage only mentioned that aggression is the result of an abnormally low neural regulation of aggressive impulses, not of testosterone. So that's why this is an option which has a trap for us. We check fourth one as well before we mark third as the answer. So fourth option says, if the alleged aggressive act is not sought to be avoided, it cannot really be considered aggression. So this option directly comes from the first paragraph where we saw discussion and definition of aggressive behavior. So this directly is implied from the passage. So what is not implied is option number three. And that's why third one will be marked as the answer to this question. Question number eight says, the author discusses all of the following arguments in the passage except that. So three options will hold good and one will not. The one that doesn't will be our answer. So let's examine the options. Men in general are believed to be more hormonally driven to exhibit violence than women. This is the argument that is found in the last paragraph of the passage. So somewhere here. And cultures also indicate that men overall are more likely to engage in a variety of aggressive behaviors compared to women. So this option directly comes from the passage, so it cannot be your answer eliminated. Second option says, several studies indicate that aggression may have roots in the biological condition of humanity. So there are biological factors that many of the scientists have put forth. So biological factors are responsible. So this option also holds good. So this cannot be selected. So let's eliminate this option. Third option says, aggression in most societies is kept under control through moderating the death instinct identified by Freud. Now, this is an extension of the passage. We do not know. We simply are being told in the passage that Freud said that there is a death instinct which leads us to aggressive behaviors. How the societies curb or seek to curb that death instinct is not mentioned in the passage, and we do not have the liberty to infer that much from the passage. So third one will be an option that cannot be inferred from the passage. Or let's check fourth one as well. The nature of aggression can vary depending on several factors, including intent. This part is mentioned in the first one. Intent, based on intent, the nature of aggression can be classified as hostile or instrumental. That part we've already discussed. So only third option is the one which does not present any argument which is present in the passage. So third one is your answer for this question.